Good afternoon, everybody. I am Todd Karnofsky. I am honored to be the administrator at Archway Academy. Thank you, everyone, for being here at today's completion ceremony with Archway Academy. This school year, we started doing fundraisers, mixing up classrooms for student-led outings, and community volunteering opportunities. These were wonderful experiences for our students to support some of our local senior living facilities, open house ministries, the Clark County Food Bank, Fish of Vancouver, and more. We have an incredible class of graduates. Some are not here with us today due to their engagement in the community. Our graduates have made significant progress over their time at Archway. They have grown in many ways as workers, lifelong learners, friends, and in their independence. I'm excited to share the celebration with our families, staff members, members of the school board, our superintendent, community partners, and our students. Thank you, CTE and Kim Burhau, for all your support with our program. Thank you, Ellen Wiesner and Special Services, for all your support with our program. Thank you, Evergreen Transportation and CTRAN, for working with us on engaging in the community. Now let's get this ceremony started. I would like to welcome our Master of Ceremonies to the podium. Please give a round of applause for Timothy Batarse.
Thank you, everyone. I am Timothy Same Batarse. I will be graduating from Archway Academy today. I am currently attending Clark College and have been passing my classes each quarter for the past 2 years. I am so excited to be here and serve as your Master of Ceremonies. Oleg, Yosander, and Josh, will you please lead us in the land acknowledgement?
Each community is rooted in their respective history that has led to this moment. Today, we start our day by connecting with the histories of people on this occupied land. Some have lived on this land for more generations than can be counted. Some were brought here against their will, and some were drawn to leave their distant homes in hope of a better life for all communities. We must weave truth, reconciliation, and healing into the fabric of our culture to build mutual respect and connection among all people.
We begin.
Yep.
This effort to acknowledge what has been buried by honoring this truth. Evergreen Public Schools resides on the traditional lands and the Chinookan peoples and the cowlitz shrimp who have lived on the care for this land and its waterways since time immemorial. We thank them for stewardship. Make acknowledgement to open a space of recognition, inclusion, and respect for all Indigenous students, families, staff, and our community.
Nis dag a member of Nayot Nefson to Cicero da Mani Nesson of Parents Testament Nesson and Cicero da Gans use to get to all to get to on this to learn of Nixon and community.
Thank you, Oleg, Josh, and Yosander for reading the land acknowledgement. And now, please lead us in the flag salute.
Josh, make sure you say this, okay? Okay, you got to move out of the way.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Nice job, guys. Now it's time to hear from our superintendent. Please welcome John Boyd to the podium.
Well, Timothy, thank you. I think you'll have a career in emceeing. Outstanding job of that. And let's give a hand for Timothy. How great a job is he doing? Joshua and Yosander for the flag salute and the land acknowledgement. Oleg, great job as well. I'm so excited today to be here to recognize these completers and graduates of Evergreen Public Schools. I am lucky because my office looks right down on the school, and I get to sometimes sneak in and catch a meal when they're having soup. I get to interact with a student out on the courtyard. I've had the chance to do mock interviews with students inside the building, and I will tell you, first of all, staff, I just want to thank you for all you do to support these remarkable human beings on their journey and getting them prepared for the real world. Can we get a round of applause for this staff? Love these people, and they love the kids, and that's what it's all about. To our students, congratulations for getting to this point in your educational journey. We're so proud of what you've accomplished, and we're so excited for your future. The last thing I want to do is just recognize our families and parents who have supported these young men and women through their educational journey. This does not happen in a vacuum. It takes family, it takes friends and neighbors and support. And so let's give a hand to the people in the stands also and what they've done to support you all. So on behalf of the Board of Directors, Deputy Superintendent Dr. Kimberly Armstrong, I certify that these students have fulfilled all the requirements to complete the Archway Academies program. Congratulations, graduates.
Thank you, John. And now staff from Archway can now join me on stage. We will now hear from the one and only special ed teacher, Allison Lovell.
I know, right? Wow, thank you, Tim. Thank you. All right, good afternoon, everyone. So I'd like to start by telling my graduates from my class how proud I am of you guys today. You're the first group that started and completed at our new building at Archway, which is kind of a big deal, so congratulations. Jay, where are you? There you are, buddy. All right. So Jay, you have been such a responsible and a helpful student over the 3 years of having you. When you're in your first year at our program, you were a wonderful leader with transportation and showing the other students how to use the bus and becoming more comfortable and competent, which has really rubbed off on everyone, and they had looked to you as a leader for that. So thank you, Jay. And you are the only one in our class right now with paid employment, which is awesome. You work at Chartwell's 5 days a week over at Pacific Middle School, which is excellent. And you've had such a positive attitude. You're a very polite young man, and I'm really grateful to have had you in my class. I wish you all the best, Jay. Esmeralda, since your first year with me over 3 years ago, you have made such progress in your independence and your confidence. You're now one of the class experts at using transportation, and you do a fantastic job, and we have student-led outings at being a leader and making sure everybody gets exactly where they need to go. You've also been a part of our leadership committee this year, and you've done a fabulous job with that of organizing different activities for the school and making sure student voice is heard. And next year, I'm really going to miss your positive attitude and your smile and your ability to get along with everybody. So good luck in your future endeavors. Thank you. JL, you have also shown a lot of growth over the past 3 years. You have really come far in developing a great work ethic in the classroom and at your coffee cart work site. And you did a fabulous job of socializing with other students and always come to school with a smile on your face and a kind word for others. I know you have the potential to do well in your future adventures, and I wish you all the best. My last completer, he's not here today, but his name is Parker, and he was with me for just a short period of time, but I really have enjoyed having Parker in my class. He has a great personality. He is always so excited about whatever the day holds. Some of my favorite memories of having him in class is when he would share his love of cats with us and often meow or do cats chattering noises. And how much he enjoyed going on community-based instructions every Wednesday. So all the best to Parker, too. Okay, congratulations, you guys. And up next is Charlie Jenkins.
I'd like to start with, since we're giving thanks to people, I'd like to thank two gentlemen who don't get heard from very much. My two student volunteers who were former students of mine, Eric Kvass and Tavai Portisano. They have been invaluable to our program. So I'm going to start with the students I have. First is Tim, who's our MC today. He's been studying, as he said, out at Clark College for 2 years, studying 2D animation. And he hopes to continue his education and eventually work in that field. He's currently living at home with his family, but he does hope at some point to be able to have a place to live. He has also distinguished himself in our school leadership program. He's a fantastic personality to be on the leadership team. My second one is Allison Rowe. Allison has been, there's her cheering squad. Allison's been working independently at home and has been doing some amazing projects there. She has worked, working with DVR to get a job, and She hopes to be able to work with animals when she gets through with that program. All right, my third one is the one that's leaving us a little early. That's Chris. Chris has decided to finish up with our program after 1 year. He is currently working with DVR also to gain employment. His goal is to work to live independently in an apartment with me with a roommate. Chris expertly navigates our community on CTRAN, and you can, in his free time, you can see him traveling all over the Portland metro area as and practicing for that. And then lastly, I have Caleb Smithland. Caleb has been with me for 3 years. There we go. He has grown incredibly over those 3 years. He has been able to do work assignments, and he's very hard worker in class. Caleb is also going to be working with DVR and hopes to have a job, especially at Wild Wings, where he loves their spicy hot wings. And Caleb has a signature move, and I would like to send him off with everybody doing his signature move. He likes to call the group together by going like this. Okay, could everybody do that and show Caleb we love him? There we go. All right, so that's my group, and now I'd like to introduce Anna Koivu to celebrate her group.
Thank you, Charlie. Good afternoon. Thank you for joining us today to celebrate these young adults. When students are presented with high expectations and the supports they need along the way, they thrive. It has been such a pleasure getting to work so closely with four of our completers and their families over the past 3 years. A special camaraderie has developed with these four students from my room, making this a unique group to have at the same time. Through humor, teachable moments, and opportunities to learn in a variety of environments, each of these students have grown in their leadership and independence. Matthias Hollander. Matthias has a great sense of humor and has enjoyed connecting with his peers at Archway. He has worked hard to increase his independence during his time at Archway, requiring less support for daily living tasks such as meal prep. Matthias has gained work experience at retail thrift store and Evergreen Public Schools Transportation. He is participating in the Job Foundation's program through Trillium and working toward finding part-time supported employment. Matthias played unified basketball and soccer with the teams at Union High School. He also enjoyed going swimming, taking the bus to a variety of community-based outings in Vancouver and Portland. Congratulations, Matthias. Josh Hill. Josh is caring and kind to everyone around. He has an eye for detail and strives to always do the best job possible. This year, he has continued gaining job experience working at Seize the Bagel. He has participated in the Yes Employment class and is also enrolled in the Job Foundation's program through Trillium. He has completed a few different job samples and is working to find a supported employment position. Josh is also an athlete, playing both unified basketball and soccer with the teams at Evergreen High School. He has also enjoyed sharing his love of trains with others. Our visit to the Oregon Rail Heritage Center was one of his favorite outings. Congratulations, Josh. Oleg Prokopenko. Oleg is a hard worker and fiercely independent. This year, he has advocated to have more time at worksite learning, gaining job experience at two sites while having less classroom time at school. He worked in the kitchen at Union High School in the morning and Furstenberg Community Center in the afternoon. At both work sites, Oleg was independent, completing a variety of tasks and keeping himself on schedule. He has participated in the Yes Employment class and is also enrolled in the Job Foundation's program through Trillium. He has applied for a part-time position with Chartwells and hopes to begin paid employment in the fall. Oleg is a leader and is happy to assist those around him. He also loves being active, lifting weights, swimming, and playing both unified basketball and soccer with the teams at Evergreen High School. Congratulations, Oleg. Yosander Robles. Yosander is funny and uses his sense of humor to make connections and build rapport with people around him. During his time at Archway, he played unified basketball with the teams at Evergreen and Heritage High School and participated in student leadership. Yosander has grown immensely in his ability to advocate for his needs, wants, and state his preferences. He is self-assured and willing to try new things and take risks. He is confident in his ability to schedule transportation using C-Van, travel to and from his destination, and complete his errand independently. Yosander is receiving vocational rehabilitation support from the Department of Services for the Blind and is actively applying for part-time positions. He has also participated in the Yes Employment class and is hoping to participate in the summer paid internship program. Congratulations, Yosander. In closing, I would like to thank each of these students for their courage and willingness to take risks, try new things, and grow beyond what's comfortable and routine. I would also like to thank the families for your advocacy and collaboration in creating uniquely individualized transition programs for your learners. Finally, I would also like to thank my team of amazing paraeducators who helped make all of the planning a reality. Thank you so much. Now from Kim.
Good afternoon, everyone. I know everybody listens to my voice every morning, but I'm going to make you listen again. First of all, I would like to say that I am very honored to have been given the opportunity to speak for my last time today and talk about our program and two of our completers. I'd also like to give special thanks to our administrator, Todd Karnofsky. For all the support he's given me each and every day. He's always supporting my ideas for Archway Academy. Here's where I tear up. And let me roll with them. With his support, we started morning announcements at Archway, created our yearbook for the last 2 years, started our first ever mini career fair, and I started an office procedures program that I'm really proud of. I've had my fingers in a couple other projects as well, and I have loved every minute of it. And loving every minute is literally an understatement. I would also like to thank and give kudos to my staff, Karen McDonald. There you are. I literally could have not done it without her. We are confidants, we talk, we know our kids, and we love, this is where I'm really gonna cry, teaching together. As students and teachers, we have made many, many memories together. This is my last and final year of me teaching at Archway Academy, and it's been literally the best yet. With all this being said, I'd like to talk now about the first of my two completers. I'm looking over at you. I've had Wyatt Cruz as a student since he first started at Archway. I've seen Wyatt grow as a student and become a leader in his class. On community outings, Wyatt consistently helps out with the travel planning of the outings, can utilize community resources, and plan out the C-Tron bus routes immediately. I know I've been in your class and you've done it way faster than I ever could ever possibly do it. Wyatt loves hanging out with his friends, going to the mall, and having them over to his house for gaming and role-playing. After Archway, he has plans on getting a job as a barista, and with his communication skills and how friendly he is, I have no doubt that you'll be able to achieve that. And now on to my last completer that I like to call my guinea pig. I've had Marius Stokes last semester in my Technology and Career Choices class. He's a great student in person. I decided to implement the Office Procedures class second semester so students could experience having an authentic setting assisting the front office secretaries. I had Marius and a few other students in mind for this class, and I asked Marius if he would be my guinea pig, helping me figure out if the class would work and working out all the details before bringing on the others. His response was, "Yes, boss lady," and that's where our names have been ever since. Marius proved that the class was indeed viable and a good fit for Archway Academy. He has all the skills necessary to be a great receptionist. He has a really good work ethic. He's very professional as a student. He works towards our common goals for the class, has great oral communication skills with students and adults alike, and is able to maintain confidentiality at all times for this type of position. I know that Marius really wants this type of job as a career after leaving Archway Academy. I know he will achieve this goal. So, my little guinea pig, go out and do your best always. Remember to use me as a reference, as I already know how great you are. So, Archway completers, you've studied hard and learned so much. You're prepared for the future and everything it holds for you. I've had so much fun teaching you, laughing with you. I'm such a baby. Talking with you, learning from you, and seeing you grow and turn into the person you are today. Congratulations, graduates, today and always. You've really worked really hard on your goals. I told myself I would not do this, so you guys, you graduates, it's all your fault. And now you're on your way to achieving them. Thank you. Next up is our wonderful special ed teacher, Claudia Pepin.
Hey now, my name is Claudia, and I'd like to give a big shout out to the graduating students, the parents, and the staff that work so hard to develop these young peoples in every area of their life. I'd like to give a shout out to my staff assistants, Kim, Dawn, Monica, who's out having a baby, Pat, and Micah. They work so hard, I could never do anything without them. They are wonderful staff assistants, and let's give them a round of applause. I also want to give a round of applause to Veronica. Wave your hand, Veronica. She travel trains all our students on C-Tran and teaches them how to ride the buses back and forth, how to schedule their own C-Van rides. And she is a great addition to our program. Thank you, Veronica. To the class of 2024, despite some hard tasks, sadness, and grief that you encountered in the course of your studies in the transition program, at the end of it all, you completed this part of your journey with great achievements and beautiful memories. A special congratulations to Mason Hagen. He's this one of the students in my class. Most of my students, half of my students were nonverbal, and my supervisor, Todd, came to me early in the year and asked me if I would be willing to teach ASL. And I said yes, because I always say yes to everything, but I had to learn with my students. So we all learned ASL this year, and we had a wonderful time. Mason learned ASL too. He has been a great addition to our classroom. He is friendly and now very talkative. He also communicates with American Sign Language. He works well in the group, and he makes a mean pancake. He works in Nora's class, and Miss Nora is our cook, and they cook a lot of wonderful things, but Mason's specialty is pancakes. He always does his work on time, and I'm going to miss Mason so much. I love him, and I congratulate him on graduating from the transition program. And the next one of my students that I want to talk about is Kenneth. Kenneth has worked hard, developed work skills needed to become a productive member of society. Upon leaving Archway Academy, Kenneth will be gainfully employed at Cascade Middle School, working in a cafeteria. Let's give Kenneth a hand. He was actively involved in the leadership team, and his attendance was impeccable. The very best to you all in all your endeavors. I would like to call on one of my staff assistants, Micah O'Keefe.
Hello and good afternoon. I have the honor to be standing up here to talk about JW.
This was his first year and his last year at the transition program. But throughout the time, he has learned and grown so much. He learned to speak for himself through his language, ASL, and through his speaking device. The joy of working with JW is just a wonderful feeling walking around with him and having him greet everyone he sees with a good morning and a fist bump. He also learned to advocate for himself on his needs, telling us that he was hungry with ASL, that he wanted a hamburger and french fries. He was a wonderful addition to this year, and he will sorely be missed. Congratulations, JW, and we are excited to see where you go and how you grow. Up next, I would like to introduce the SLP, Tanya.
Good afternoon, everybody. I wanted to just say a few words for three students who couldn't be here today, but yet had a big impact on Archway and our community. The first is Luke Murray. Luke greets the world with enthusiasm and kindness. He has brought joy and good humor to the halls of Archway since coming on as a second-year student last year. During Luke's time here, he has made many friends, both in his own class and in others here at Archway. He is always quick with a smile, and he has a great sense of humor. Luke has incredible manners, and after every communication lesson I teach in his classroom, Luke will go out of his way to say, "Thank you, Tanya, for that lovely time in speech." His general positive view of the world uplifts others, and just like the speech lesson example, Luke has a lovely time doing most things. He greatly enjoyed his work at Friends of the Carpenter this year, and when Luke enjoys something, he is generous in sharing his positivity and enthusiasm. He loves to travel, dance, and is not afraid to try new things. He has added so much warmth and light to the community here at Archway. We will miss you, Luke. I have no doubt that you will go on to enjoy many adventures and make many new friends in the years to come. Sammy Martinez in Claudia's class. Sammy is a born adventurer. He independently rode his bike to school and back and forth every day. Sammy knows what he likes and what he enjoys. His love of working out and basketball made it very easy for him to connect with others who shared his interests. I remember during one Halloween party where there was a ping pong tournament of sorts where students had to throw a ball into a cup to get a point, and Sammy made every single shot. The other students could not stop high-fiving him, and he loved celebrating with them. Sammy's ability to tell stories using his gestures and facial expressions show the character of someone who does not give up and wants to connect with others. I know Sammy will continue to explore his community and make many new friends along the way. Sammy will be missed here at Archway next year. And finally, Juliet Young in Charlie's class. I first worked with Juliet when she was in seventh grade at Cascade Middle School. I was so excited to see her again when I arrived at Archway last year. Last year, Juliet primarily attended the community-based instruction events on Wednesdays, and I always enjoyed when I'd have the opportunity to spend time with Juliet on these trips. During the travel training on the bus, Juliet would always share pictures of all of the places in the world that she would like to visit. Her knowledge of the seven continents, the major countries, and the cities, and the wonders of many of these amazing places on Earth always amazed me and made me add new places I discovered through her to my travel list. This year, I was incredibly pleased to see Juliet expand her horizons here at home, from coming one day a week to often all 5 days, and even working as an office assistant here at Archway. She has grown so much over the past year in terms of advocating for her needs, increasing her flexibility, and becoming an essential member of her classroom in the Archway community. We will miss you so much, Juliet. I hope you get to go to many of the places that you dream about, and that you continue your curiosity and your love of learning about the world, and you continue to engage in your community and explore what is right around the corner. Congratulations.
Great job, staff. Now it is time for our first student speaker, Wyatt Cruz.
Thank you, Timothy. Hi, my name is Wyatt Cruz, and I want to say that I'm very excited to graduate. I would just like to thank all my staff and teachers for working with me. It is a pleasure to graduate from Archway Academy. Before I graduate, here are a few jokes. Anyways, why did chickens cross the road?
I don't know. Why, Wyatt?
To get to the other side. Why did Nemo touch the boat?
Well, I don't know, Wyatt. Why?
Because I don't want him to get kidnapped by a scuba diver. Why couldn't the 11-year-old get into a pirate movie?
I don't know, Wyatt. Why?
It was rated R. That's all my time, folks. Have a great afternoon and beautiful people.
Thank you, Wyatt. Great job. Please welcome Esmeralda Gil Salazar.
Oh. Hi, my name is Esmeralda, and I am a student at Archway Academy. My school taught me more about life than anything else. My teachers helped me find a job and supported me. I enjoyed traveling on C-Tran and the MAX. I feel more comfortable riding public transportation now. Some of my favorite outings were OMSI and the zoo. Learning how to use C-Tran and go to different transit centers was really important. I learned a lot while working at Pipsqueaks and also had a summer internship there, and where I received my first paycheck. Working at Pipsqueaks really prepared me for a paid job at school. Being around with my friends was like a second family to me. We always hang out with each other and spent a lot of time together. This year, as part of the leadership team, I got several opportunities to talk to the school. That was really fun because it made me feel comfortable talking in front of many people. Thank you, Mom and Dad, for letting me go to Archway Academy to learn more. After graduation, I plan to work at a paid job. Thank you for being here today and supporting all of us in our journeys.
That was wonderful of you, Esmeralda. Thank you very much for sharing that with us. And now, Allison Rowe has a special treat for all of us. She's going to sing Fight Song by Rachel Platten.
Like a small bird on the ocean, sending the big waves in motion. And a single word can make the door open. Give me that one message son. Take back my life, son. Take my right, son. My power is turned on. Stay right now, I be strong. I lay my fight, son. Sending big waves in the ocean. Like how a single word can make a heart open. I might only have one wish, but I can make an explosion. This is my fight, son. Take back my life, son. Live my right, son.
Nice job, Allison! Thank you for sharing your talents with us! Thank you for sharing your talents with us! And now our graduates can stand up and line up by the stage!
All right, please join us in celebrating all of our graduates for the 2023-24 school year. I would like to start by presenting a diploma to Timothy Batarse. Come on, Tim. All right, Tim.
Thanks.
And now, Tim, will you read the rest of the names for us?
Okie dokie, Esmeralda Gil Salazar. Wyatt Cruz. Allison Rowe. Jay Ames. Jay Ames. Christopher Godet. Mason Hagen. Joshua Hill. Matthias Hollander. J.L. Macias. John J.W. Mickles. Ole Prokopenko. Yosander Robles. Kenneth Smith. Caleb Smithlin. And last but not least, Marius Stott. And now let's give a round of applause for all of our graduates. Thank you, staff, for everything you have done to support us all at Archway. Thank you, families, for all your love and support, even to my mother, Iklaas. Hello, Iklaas! Hello, Mother! We are looking forward to the future. Feel free to take pictures with your graduate on the track. There are some light snacks and refreshments available. Have a wonderful weekend, everybody!
Hope when you take that jump, you don't feel the fall.